he's identified as a black American, but then at the same time,
what up, what up? It's your boy Shady C here at Brightline. About to do the VIP thing. Check this out, yo. Don't know how we get our ticket, but I got the ticket on my phone. I'm finna show them. Just got done with my NCL interview. So, I gotta go back to West Palm. The Brightline style. I'm gonna check this out. Now remember, I'm gonna rate the VIP little waiting room area. I'm gonna rate the check-in process. I'm gonna rate the train, everything. And yeah. Yeah, Shady C back again. I came up this big old escalator. Got my ticket. So we come up with Chong. Big bag, no, it's not really big. Skin here, I assume. Wait. Okay, it's doing it. We're working on it. Okay. Early for your trip. Want to book the next one? No. Wait, it's 1:40 now. I could easily do that. That'll give me enough time to... Yeah, let's do that. You've updated your boarding pass. Okay, so it's 1:41 right now. It gives me more enough time to be able to explore. Look a little bit, eat a little bit. Okay. Departs at 4:10. Hey, how you doing?
All right. Yes,
sir. First timer.
All right. Definitely enjoy it, man.
Cool, cool. So just make sure I did this right. What you call it? This is the, I got the VIP one, right?
Yeah, first class.
Cool, cool.
Select lounge. But you did get it for 5:10.
What you mean?
5:10 p.m.?
Yeah, I just changed it to 4:10.
Okay.
You had to think, an option, if you want to do it earlier or not, suggest.
Okay.
Not a problem. So, do 4:10? I update?
There's going to be a 2:10 meeting right now.
No, I want to kind of like explore a little bit.
Okay, that's fine.
So, is it going to, since I updated it, is there a way to like, change the time on there? Or?
You can downstairs, but you're already inside.
Maybe. Yeah, so it's not a big deal, really.
It's not a big deal.
Cool, cool. I'm a YouTuber too, so I like to like, when I do something, record a little bit.
Your ticket, the select lounge is going to be down there.
It's down there.
Same way, you'll scan it in and you'll be able to go and fill out.
All right, cool. Thank you. Hey, let me ask you a question real quick. Yeah. Since this is my first time, I'm just kind of curious. I didn't move the camera away. Well, like, they said that on the train, they have, like, food and beverages and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, what kind of stuff?
I believe it's one cocktail and water, soda,
okay.
Coffee. Yeah, which okay. Also, not in a select lounge, uh-huh. You get those as amenities.
Oh, cool.
The water, coffee, sodas. They also have some chips and some protein snacks that are open.
Okay, all right, cool. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Cool, cool. Check this out, yo. He said one cocktail. I hope. It won't really just like one. Yo, everybody, you come over here. This is where you can pick up your little like snacks and stuff. This stuff here is not included with the ticket, right? I know that. I'm doing a YouTube video, so I'm trying to like let everybody know about this. Look, good to go. She cute, but she grumpy though. Whew. Let's see, scan Chong. Okay. Okay, let's see. Nice big ass area. I wonder if they have a place to charge my phone. We're finna find out.
That's why that's a business center.
You would think they would. Yo, they do. They got plugs right here. Look at that, yo. And this is a little VIP section. You got a whole bunch of plugs. I didn't see that before. Okay. And they got soda down here. Water down here.
Hello.
Okay, okay. Got coffee here. Ooh. This is pretty cool. They got chips. And they got some like little treat. Gotta give me some of this, yo. See y'all later.
Yo, what up? It's your boy Shady C here again in this VIP lounge. I got me one of these things. I had one already. It was pretty good. One of these things. Had me a few bags of potato chips. Got me a Diet Pepsi. Yes, they have regular. And I got me a cup of coffee. As y'all know, I don't normally drink coffee, but it's free. I might even grab a bag of salt and vinegar potato chips. I don't even like them at all. But look at this area, yo. I cannot say enough positive things. Got a beautiful view overlooking the gorgeous area of Miami for the most part, but there's a lot of construction. But look at this. Look at all this. And so far, my favorite thing, you can plug your phone in and charge it up. Can't beat that. Can't beat that. I've met a lot of the staff so far. Everybody's been real nice, real friendly, real cool. I'm gonna tell you what, if they ever decide to completely expand into all of Tri-Rail's markets, they finna go out of business. Let them get one in Mongonia. Definitely. Let them get one in Mongonia. Tri-Rail finna go out, especially because Tri-Rail got a lot of rude employees. So far, every employee I met has been real cool. I changed my ticket. Originally, I had it set to 5. But I changed it up a little bit. Oh, there's some more stuff over there I didn't notice. I don't even know. I need to check all that stuff out. But yeah, I'm loving it so far. There's no complaints. Nothing negative to say. Remember, stay tuned because you will see on the train. I left it on everything that your boy is going to be filming on this train. So we're going to see what's going on. I'm trying to drag it out because I want the lady that took my ticket is going to change the time on it. I want to get her on camera. I would like to at least. But anyways, see y'all in a little bit. So, are you a smoker at Brightline? Well, guess what you got to do? You got to leave your nice little lounge. And you got to go all the way around. All the way down here. Just to go smoke a cigarette. That is definitely craziness. Look, I just went on 2 escalators. This is the 3rd escalator. Going downstairs. Turn around, going down. Just to go smoke a cigarette. Really, yo? I get you like to ostracize smokers. I feel you. Well, I don't feel you, but I understand what you like to do. You know, you like to separate us. But this is a little ridiculous. So there's some negative things. Like Amy told me that she was going to give me a new ticket. Because my ticket got the old time on it. I changed it to 410. And I ain't seen her since then. I ain't seen nobody since then. So I'm going to go outside real quick. I'm gonna have my little cigarette out, you know, being ostracized and all that. I do it that way, apparently. So, now this is what you gotta do. I'm gonna go outside and smoke a cigarette. Yo, look at the ass on that chick right there, yo. Booty be just too nice. Look at that. She's shaking it, too. Look at that. She know people be looking at that ass. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. He just like, damn. Let me grab it real quick. See if he does it. Look at that. Girl just be shaking that ass. Okay, so I'm back in the little VIP area. I mean, I guess everything in life has positives and negatives, but there's more positives to here, definitely. The only real negative is the fact that you gotta go to Timbuktu if you wanna smoke a cigarette. I mean, that's no bueno. Because I'm gonna tell you what, you know, based on the amount of time you're here, you might wanna smoke Moto once. Sorry, check with a nice booty walk by and kinda distract me for a minute. You might wanna smoke Moto once. But I guess the lounge is designed for like, supposed to be like, you know, maybe you'd be like 30 minutes early. You come to the lounge, you have a little snack. But I came a lot early. But good news is, I got my updated ticket. So we will arrive in West Palm Beach at 5:25 p.m. It's going to be interesting to see how far I am from the homeless shelter. It's going to be interesting to see how far away I am from it. I don't know, so we'll see. Yo, so we're leaving the VIP area, going out to the boarding. Now boarding on track two, that's where we're gonna be going. Let's see, look at the old people in front of me. I'm trying to film granny and grandma. I'm trying to, but I am, unfortunately, but look. That's a big ass escalator. Ain't no joke, yo. Wait, let's try to see if we can film the chick up ahead of the grandma. See if she got good. Wow. She do, I can't lie. So we come up here, and there's a Bright Line train. I always get nervous stepping off an escalator. I always get nervous.
Did you get it right now?
Yes, I did.
You weren't sitting there when I crossed by and I wanted to get it to you.
I was waiting because I wanted to get you on camera.
Aww.
This is Ashley.
Hi.
This is the hot chick I was talking about earlier. And this is another hot chick. So this is the train I'm going to be on.
Yes, sir.
Where do I go? Go in that
door? So you're going to go to where it says coach number one, all the way down to where Mr. Joey is. And then you can actually assist you with finding your seat. Your seat number is in the aisle for you.
Now, if you come to Bright Line, you get to see these beautiful ladies.
Have a great trip.
Thank you. You too. Fortunately, they're a little too overdressed, but what can we do about that? Vote. Write Bright Line. Email. We want bikinis. That would be best for business. Hey, let me ask you something. I was thinking about something. I just want to kind of know your opinion. If I get all my viewers to email Brightline and suggest that the ladies here wear bikinis, what are the odds of that happening?
You'd have to get that cleared as my boss.
Like, if we can get millions of people to email your boss and say, look, we need Ashley in a bikini.
I'm flattered, but I don't think that that's going to happen.
Okay, but that would be cool, though. Thank you very much. She's cool. She got a good sense of humor, too, which is nice. She trying not to be offended, though. I think that's adorable. Okay. Track two, coach one. So going right, y'all, right? Yes, sir. Alright, cool. Seat number 43. Select one. Okay, so. Okay. Yo, this is cool. Okay, and this number, that's nice. Like that. Seat number 43. What's 43? Right, Sean. Okay.
And there's a little tray. Look at that. Look at that, yo. A lot of room. There's a lot of room. Even a fat man. Look. This is very fat friendly. I want to say to the bathrooms, they were fat friendly. I meant to record what I saw. I went into the family restroom, and they had a chair. Not like a toilet chair. I mean, it had that too, but they had like a place to just sit and recline in the bathroom. I was like, what? What's this right, y'all? It looks like you should be able to pull it down, but you can't. But look at that, yo. Hold on. Seat 43. Kind of want to look around.
Yeah, but there's no way to put this.
Can I ask you a question? I'm doing a YouTube video. My subscribers want to kind of like know some things. So this area here, would someone have to pay extra to get that or?
This is select, yes.
Well, no. I mean, like, I'm in select, but like if you wanted this specific chair here, no. It would just be the regular select price?
Yes.
Okay. And I'm just kind of like getting a lay, looking around. Like, I know a lot of people who want to try Brightline, but they're like, yo, do a video first. Let's see what's up. I gotta.
It cannot be filmed on camera.
Oh, okay. I kinda like, I'm pointing it downward. You're not.
Thank you.
This is what's gonna be on. I'm looking at, right, the list of stuff. Gourmet coffee, tea, refreshing soda, wine and spirits, cold beer.
Yeah, so I think you'll have to go on this way regardless because of this. But through the eye, I mean.
It can't be on camera. Are they wanted by the federal government? Do we not know something? We need to know, people.
Yeah.
Seat number 43, where was I at? See, it seems like the people on train are a little too serious. I don't know, we might need to work on that. But I like the people I met in there so far. I don't know, sometimes it seems like I've said before, people, there's a difference between nice and pleasant. I like nice. Sometimes it seems like some people in like this type of thing, they just more pleasant than nice. Let's look at this. What's this? Welcome aboard. Okay. Your backyard just got bigger. West Palm Beach. Okay. Kind of like showing you what's going on. I feel it. I want to know what they're going to have for snacks and whatnot. See, I don't know. That's a $7 beer. That's more expensive than a $5 milkshake. Pulp Fiction reference, people. Look at it. Nipples. Soft drink be $2. But it's gonna be free for me. Why don't they put a list of like... Oh, that's for the select guests. Okay, I see the difference. Okay. For select guests, we not select, we better than that. But I want to see what it says for the other guests. Don't really say nothing. But this is kind of cool. A little bonus thing they throw in there, apparently. Faster booking flexibility, and that says packs and passes. You'll enjoy a greater convenience and travel. Never expire and connections are available so you can share. That's pretty cool. These are some of the prices, yo. Monthly pass, save up to 20% with unlimited rides for a month. That's pretty cool. I'm liking this little thing right, chaw. So what I wonder is, do you go, oh, I see what that, okay, that's what that was. That thing right there, that's this right here. What I'm wondering is, do we get up and get the snacks we want, or do they bring them to us? I don't know. This is gonna be interesting, folks. Stay tuned. Look at this, yo. Can't lie, this is tight. See, it looks real fancy and nice, too. I like this fold-out tray they got. You gotta remember, yo, this is 90 minutes. This is not that long. So I wish I would hurry up. Let a brother see what's good. This room is incredible, though. The space, yeah. They brought around a free sample called an Abro Spritz. I just heard her tell someone else it's an Italian import. We're going to try it here. I've never tried it, so we're going to try it here together. Well, I'm going to try it. Okay, Robert, I know you're the wine guy, but I don't know how you do it. My eyes are watering. This is not good. Wine is not good. Yo, what up? Got a rum mixed drink. Life is good. Very strong. Yo, we can't lie, the bathroom is nice. To lock or open the door, you just press that little button right there. They have a trash recycle area. Go back to where I was at. Look at that, it opens nice. Cool, cool. Ooh, wine and gummy bears. Not wine, sorry. Rum, I meant to say rum and gummy bears. I want to see if it makes a taste difference. Both the gummy bears and the rum. See if they soak into it. I'm gonna like let it sit here for a little bit for a little while. No, we are literally in Boca Raton right now, just past Boca Elementary School. This is pretty freaking cool. I don't recall seeing that on the Chiro train, but this is pretty cool to be in Boca. I'm in Boca right now. We're heading back up to West Palm. Yeah, that's on the screen. Yo, what up? It's your boy Shady C back again. Now that wine, the wine people was passing out free swag, so I got me a shirt. So, yeah, this is kind of cool. Look out the window. Exit this way. Exit. It's out. It's left. Get off the job. So we come in here. Baggage claim. Look at that big, they like big escalators, I've noticed. It's just what do you call it? When you notice something, observation. They like big escalators. Maybe it makes it feel like a bigger place. Remember, stand by, you won't get my final thoughts in a little bit. So, some surprises, some things I expected. Some of the surprises were positive, some of them was negative. Wish that little kid would have got out the way. I'm trying to get her mom on video. Self-checkout. Let's see, now this is a little different. We got this section is huge over here. I guess that's like the regular section. That's like the regular average Joe kind of section, I guess. Lounge, I guess, is upstairs. Trax is downstairs, apparently. Okay. Okay, I see. I see. Let's see outside the window. I wonder, is this like just another part of the regular lounge, or I don't think this is the select lounge. I do not think this is select. Nah, there's no snacks over here. Hey, how you doing? Exit. Exit. Pickup. Baggage claim. Do we gotta do that thing? Okay.
Yo, what up? It's your boy Shady C here. And as you saw, that was my experience on the Brightline train. Now, as to rate it, on a scale of 1 to 10, the waiting area, that's a 10 all day. That was amazing. The train, it feels like it's a little disingenuous because when you read the description before you buy your ticket, it do say snacks. It don't tell you how many you get, but in reality, you get one snack on the train. So, yeah. So I'm going to get a train experience itself. A 7, so we're gonna rate it up, say it's like an 8.5. If you got the money, definitely I recommend it. If you can't afford it and it's squeezing the budget a little bit, take the Tri-Rail. But anyways, if you agree with me, hit that like, subscribe, and share. If you don't, you can still hit that like, subscribe, and share. Post comments down below. Have you taken Brightline? If you did, what'd you think? As you know, this Shady C, and I'm always right.